For the first step of our search engine scraping project, we're going to do the obvious thing, enter a search and return the search engine results. We'll start by importing the Selenium web driver, which will allow us to open and manipulate a web browser. We'll create a function with only one argument, the search term that we'd like to query. Let's create a variable and store our search engine website as a string. Next, we'll open up the Firefox driver and navigate to the URL we assigned. Let's do this manually for a second. Here's the search box that we'll enter our query into. Now we just need to uniquely identify the element. Since the search box has its own ID, it's easy for us to find that single element. We can pass our argument, search term, into the search box input. And since we don't have any other form fields, we can submit the form without any other interaction. Let's check to see what we need to be looking for in the search engine results. We can see that there are ads at the top of the page that look similar to the results themselves. We'll need to keep that in mind to avoid returning ads as search results. The link itself is nested inside an H3 tag. So if it weren't for the ads, we could just search for the H3 tags that have a link. But to be safe, we'll account for both situations, when ads are and are not displayed, by first searching for a special ordered list class that only displays when ads are present. If that doesn't yield results, then we'll just try finding all the H3 links. We'll create an empty list to store our potential search results. Let's set up a for loop. For each individual link in the set of links that was returned to us, we want to find the href attribute for each link. I'm going to include a print statement, so as our project grows in complexity, we can see the printout of links being added. The important part is adding the links to our empty results list. We're done in the browser, so we can go ahead and close it. And now we can return the list of our links. Let's test it out. Call the function getResults with the search term of your choosing. It happens quickly, but the browser opening, navigating, and closing again is all controlled by your code. And we can check back on the terminal and we can see, yep, the top 10 results have printed to the console. We didn't utilize the return value at this point, but we will as we add to the project. Now that we've confirmed the code works properly, I want to change the Firefox browser to Phantom.js. Phantom.js lets us execute an actual browser, but without the graphical interface, since we probably don't care to have a new Firefox window pop up every time we run our code. And it works. If you like what you saw and want to learn more about Python and automation, subscribe today.